Hey, eyes and shine. Dr. Alan here, and today we're going to be talking about photophobia. And no, photophobia isn't the fear of light. That's in fact called heliophobia. Instead, photophobia is a medical term to describe someone's hypersensitivity to light, often leading to discomfort and pain, even to just kind of normal levels of light exposure. And photophobia, or light sensitivity, is a topic I've wanted to cover for some time here on this channel because it's something that I've personally struggled with even since I was just a young little kid. Typically, the symptoms of photophobia, things that people will often experience, first starts off with a discomfort or pain kind of deep within the eye or even behind the eyes. And this sort of pain can go from something really mild, just like a general discomfort, to something more extreme and literally quite painful for people. Oftentimes, some of the symptoms that people will have is kind of this aversion to bright lights, often needing to kind of cover their eyes or even type of squinting of the eyes to try and block out so much light. And I personally remember, even as a kid, before I had access to things like sunglasses, I would often just walk around with one eye closed because I think it kind of halved the amount of light energy entering into my visual system. And interestingly enough, even in the eye clinic, during an eye exam, for people who are really light sensitive and struggle with photophobia, they often not only like instinctively like turn away and almost like try to shield themselves from the bright light that we're using to examine their eyes, but they even can't control some of the other symptoms, such as tearing of their eyes. Oftentimes their eyes just start watering when light is exposed to them. And then there's even something called a Bell's phenomenon, or a Bell's reflex, which technically is called a palpebral oculogyric reflex. This is actually a fascinating defense mechanism where your eyes roll upward and outward whenever there's something that your body senses as like immediate danger. It's kind of your body's natural way of trying to protect your eyes because it's such an essential vital organ. And we often see this in the clinic when we are shining light in people's eyes. They can't keep their eyes open or straight because they naturally want to roll up and out. And that's also the exact reason why the inferior part of the cornea is most likely to be damaged from like an abrasion or a scratch or something like that. Just try to imagine if there was an accident of some kind where something was about to hit you in the face and you realized that just a fraction of a second before it hit you, your eyes would close, but your cornea and your eye would rotate up and out to try and protect that cornea. Yes, the eyes in the human body are just fascinating. All right, so I put on my scrubs because now let's talk about what causes photophobia, or what kind of medical conditions or scenarios would cause somebody to be so light sensitive. Usually if somebody is light sensitive, it could be directly caused by some eye conditions or eye diseases, but can also be caused by problems in the brain or the central nervous system. In fact, interestingly enough, some of the research that's coming out is finding that maybe it's not even directly related to the eye much at all, but is in fact because of excitation of the trigeminal nerve, as a lot of people who are blind can still be light sensitive, right? That's pretty crazy and fascinating. But for most people, if it is related to an eye issue, it has to do with inflammation of the eye, such as maybe after an eye surgery, or if somebody has an eye disease like uveitis, which is, if you've never heard of that, an extreme form of inflammation inside of the eye. It can be due to irritation from contact lenses, maybe an abrasion or scratch on the eye, and even from dry eye syndrome. These can all be causes of photophobia. Plus any other eye diseases, things that can either cause damage to the iris, the colored part of the eye, or maybe causes pigment loss in the back of the eye, such as people with albinism, or maybe retinitis pigmentosa, for example. By the way, is it true that people with light-colored blue eyes maybe are more sensitive to light? This is something that I know myself and a lot of other doctors have kind of questioned, and it seems maybe true, but I tried to do some research and I couldn't find a definitive answer or even some research giving like true legitimacy to this sort of result. But there have been sort of thoughts that maybe people with light-colored eyes, that light maybe passes through the iris a lot easier, or that if you have light-colored eyes, maybe you don't have as much pigment in the back of the eye to sort of stop the bouncing scatter of light within the retina. Again, these are just sort of theories, but please let me know in the comments section if you're somebody who has blue eyes or just light-colored eyes and also feel like your eyes are super sensitive. And if you happen to find any research on that exact subject, please send it my way. Now, there are a couple other major causes of photophobia, one of which is that of concussions. In fact, about 70% of people with post-concussion syndrome syndrome will have light sensitivity. And then there's also people of migraine sufferers. People with migraines report about 80% of people will have light sensitivity during a migraine attack, and almost 40% of people who suffer from migraines just have light sensitivity all the time. Also, there is this list of medications which are known to cause light sensitivity, as well as people with fibromyalgia, and even people with autism spectrum disorder have a higher risk of having light sensitivity as well. So yes, both the eyes and the brain and the central nervous system play huge roles in our light sensitivity and photophobia. So now, what can we do about it? What are our options for photophobia treatment? So first, I just want to start off with some practical tips, things that you can start utilizing right away after watching this video. The first thing is just try to avoid harsh incoming lights. You can do this by drawing any sort of curtains in your house or turning any sort of the blinds on the windows in your apartment. Also try switching out your light bulbs to maybe a dimming light bulb, maybe one with a softer yellow color, and avoiding any light bulbs that have like fluorescent flickers, because those sort of light bulbs are known to cause more triggers for things like migraines and light sensitivity. I know myself, I'm really sensitive to those type of fluorescent lights. If I even go into like a department store, like I've had migraines trigger like almost within 5 minutes of walking in. So yeah, try best to avoid those fluorescent lights. And then of course on your phones, tablets, computers, you can also dim the brightness down on those computer screens a little bit. I find that if I do decrease the brightness, it does tend to kind of relax my eyes and even kind of improve my, not just light sensitivity, but even my eye strain. And then of course, if you do take any of the medications on this short list, and I'll put a list of it in the description below as well. You can always talk to your provider to ask if maybe there's another medication that you could be put on instead of that one that's known to cause light sensitivity. And then of course, probably the two most common tips to deal with light sensitivity is that of wearing wide brim hats when you're outside and that of sunglasses. However, with sunglasses, although I'm a huge fan of wearing sunglasses, there are different strengths or kind of filtering powers of sunglasses. You can get really light gray ones to really dark ones that are almost even dangerous because they're so dark. There's even the transitions or photochromic type of glasses, the ones that turn from regular clear glasses indoors to sunglasses when you step outside. I know a lot of people do find those really comfortable. One little thing about sunglasses I do want to mention here is because a lot of people who are very light sensitive, they'll choose to start wearing sunglasses indoors, which can be a concerning thing. Because when you are wearing sunglasses indoors, we're afraid that people are going to train their brain and kind of bring their light threshold down and sort of adapt to the new darker tone of their world wearing those dark sunglasses inside. So it is generally kind of discouraged to wear sunglasses indoors. Now with that being said, there are a couple of brands of glasses that are designed specifically for light sensitivity and even can be worn indoors. First of which is that of the company called Avalux, which I'm the most familiar with. Avalux glasses are kind of more marketed for people with light sensitivity due to migraine, but I have had experience wearing these lenses and have had a positive effect. If you want to see my more deep dive kind of review of them as I tried them out for a full year before even making that review, I'll put a link in the YouTube card as well as in the description below so you can find that. And then there are some new lenses coming from a brand called Mywear, which comes from a company called Percept, which I haven't personally seen too much about these, but they look like really dark green lenses, and I know that they're based on some pretty strict neurological science. Again, it's just so new, they're just kind of coming out, so hopefully once we know more information, and maybe I'll get my hands on a couple of pairs of these glasses, I'll be able to do a more deep dive scientific review about the research and really what they do. And although it's very new and I personally haven't tried it yet, I think it's really cool. And something I just wanted to mention in case you start hearing more whispers of this new kind of light sensitivity glasses, things that'll help you. And then one other type of lens or pair of glasses that may bring some help is that of neuro lens. In fact, the glasses I'm wearing right now and have been testing out for some time are at least claimed and marketed to help some degree with light sensitivity. I haven't posted my full review on that. It's coming out soon, but I can tell you, at least for people with eye strain, this might be a really good option. But stay tuned because we'll deep dive into all of that in that new review video all about NeuroLensu. And then finally, there is some hope in supplementation, as there are many different research studies confirming that supplementation of lutein can increase your macular pigment optical density, or MPOD. This is a way to describe the amount of pigment in the retina and the back of the eye, which basically works as a natural sort of filter against harsh energy light, especially blue light, which has been found in other studies that the more macular pigment you have, the better your threshold is for light sensitivity, meaning more light is needed in order to even trigger that light sensitive response. The only thing of note I'll put in here is that these studies specifically finding that photophobia has been improved with this sort of supplementation, they're usually done in smaller studies. And many of the studies out there just didn't look at photophobia specifically as an outcome. Either way though, considering how great lutein is for overall eye and brain health, I think for people who are light sensitive or photophobic, this may be a great option. All right, so that was photophobia and treatment for light sensitivity in a nutshell. Please let me know what your favorite part of this video was or what your like key number one takeaway was. Otherwise, if you want to learn more about other things that are going on with light sensitivity or eye strain, please check out our full video series coming over here to the side. Otherwise, again, Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show. Keep your eye on it, and we'll see you in the next video.